Yeah, so my first topic is an update on a previous Power Hour. So pneumologist expert Dieter Köhler, who has gained some media attention in Germany because he questioned the...
What's a pneumologist?
A pneumologist. Pneumology is sort of the science of lungs and breathing.
Got it.
Okay. So he gained some media attention in Germany because he questioned the quote-unquote science behind the air pollution thresholds of safety, in particular in the debate about bans of diesel and gasoline cars in Germany, which is now on the agenda. Published a position paper laying out more details about the scientific case against these thresholds, and he got over 100 colleagues of the field to sign this. They are all doctors and scientists who are working in, pneumology and diseases related to the lung and respiratory systems. And so in this paper, they lay out what we have been discussing earlier as well. So, for example, that the scientific case is quite weak against nitrous oxides and particulate matter pollution. Because, for example, they are based on correlational studies, which means that there is no clear causation proven by the scientific papers underlying the thresholds, and so they cannot actually quantify the harm. They are just statistical calculations of potential death that cannot really be proven. And there are no actual dead bodies that you can count to actually test the hypothesis behind this. And there are also a bunch of confounding factors, that is, better explanations for why there's a higher mortality rate in a certain area with higher degrees of air pollution or higher concentrations of nitrous oxides or particulate matter. And so they laid out sort of what the scientific case for a proper threshold would be. And so this has gained, again, some media attention, also some very furious reactions by green politicians and advocates, as could be expected. And so my hope is that this will trigger a more in-depth debate of what really would be a good scientific take on the potential harm of air pollutants and what, you know, a good level of regulation would be. And that's the update.
I find this very interesting in a number of ways. One is that I'm surprised that he got so many colleagues to sign it, because in the United States, which I tend to have a view that the United States is better than Europe, and I mean better by the standard of human flourishing and better by the standard of respecting individual rights, and thus the German laws about energy tend to be much worse than the American laws, and the thresholds that they're passing are more damaging. And yet it would be surprising to me. So it'd be surprising to me in the US if we had laws as bad as Germany does, but it would be surprising to me if we had this many scientists stand up on the issue of air pollution, because it's one of these issues. It's almost like the climate issue, where you're just viewed as a denier or a believer. And thus it's hard to imagine 100 American scientists coming out publicly and saying, okay, yes, certain quantities of air pollution or air emissions can be dangerous, but these quantities, there's no evidence, are really endangering people. And thus it's harmful to have such a low threshold for air emissions because it's hurting people in these other ways. So, Steffen, do you have any ideas on why it's, do you think I'm right that it's unlikely in America? And maybe why is it is there not some big price to pay that these scientists will have? Because it seems like in the US there would be a huge price to pay.
Yeah, definitely. So this could be a career ending, you know, depending on it, how it plays out. So that's why I think so many did it, because probably behind closed doors, more people agree with it and more experts agree with the challenge Köhler put out. But so they are, I think, trying to come out in force so nobody can really like say, oh, there's scientific consensus and everyone outside this is just a denier or something like that. I'm not sure that America has less stringent standards. So in some of the concentrations thresholds, I think America is actually a trendsetter and the EPA is a trendsetter for other countries. I think what's very positive and what gives some credibility to these experts and to the sort of outside the consensus side is that now that driving bans for diesel cars, relatively new diesel cars and gasoline cars in many big German cities are on the table, this really shows the damage. So usually, you know, the general public will put up with a lot of regulations if they don't see the direct harm. But know that this impact is so threatening to everyone. And, you know, if you ban diesel cars in big cities like Cologne and Berlin and so on, that's really, not only will it hit a lot of consumers, but this actually threatens the whole economy. Everything could become more expensive, and this will do a lot of harm. And so I think this is the threshold that is met, you know, similar to the yellow vests in France, where people really get hurt. And so the damage of all these regulations really comes out and is visible to the general public.
Got it. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. And I can see the analogy.